Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me a great deal of pleasure to welcome you to this performance of Lenny Bruce at Carnegie Hall. The one thing I'd like to say about the label of sick comedian, which I think is a misnomer, what Lenny does perhaps as a short explanation to the people who don't understand what he does, it is not that Lenny Bruce per se is a sick comedian, but that Lenny Bruce comments, reflects, holds up the mirror, so to speak, to the sick elements in our society that should be reflected upon and that should be spoken about. And so at this time, ladies and gentlemen, Lenny Bruce.
Cool it. Like, I was like doing a milking thing, but it's ridiculous. You should dig my point of view here, man. It's like every dumb old RKO movie, you know. It's a golden horseshoe, you know. Yeah, there's people with a lorgnette looking at me. Yeah, it's groovy. You know, working Carnegie Hall is like, I dig it, you know. But I had a lot of fantasies with it, you know. Two great fantasies. One, he introduces me and I come out with a violin and I just cook, man. But for an hour, man, every Stravinsky heavyweight, and I don't say a word, Zugnish and I split, you know. You know, what was that, man? I don't know, it's a concert and he played a violin, man. He didn't do any bits? No, man, he just swaled his ass with a violin. No, yeah, okay. Now, number two fantasy is that, since it's the 12 o'clock scene, maybe the people who own this place don't even know we're here. Right? Yeah, you got a guy who's like a good corrupt janitor, you know? All right, but don't make no noise and clean up after you finish, right? That's it, right? That's it, right? Yeah. Okay. All right. Now, I was in Miami, see, and I got two concerts to make. Last night is Philadelphia, and then here. So now I leave Philly, so I'm going to make it 3 o'clock. Oh, yeah. I got to make a 3 o'clock Eastern airline, which will get me into Philadelphia at 7 o'clock, and I can make the concert. Okay, now I get a call at the hotel. Eastern Airlines is calling, and I go, uh-oh, must be it. All the flights have been canceled. I said, no, I got to be there, and answer. Well, there's one flight, they're going to go to, they're not going to land at Philadelphia, you can't land there, but they're going to go to Boston or Montreal. They'll be in Boston at 5:55. Well, I figure that's cool. What I'll do is I'll charter a plane from there, you know, so I'll still make it. I get there at the airport now, it's about 6:30, and I want to charter a plane. No, it's ice and sleet, and I said, no, man, there'll be some guy, I don't care, I want to make it, man. How much is it? Well, for a twin engine, the charter is like $200. So now I really got frantic, $200, $600, where actually, then I ended up offering the guy a grand, man, $1,000. I was like, gotta make it, I gotta be there. Now I got 2 hours to go, gotta be in Philly. You can't, I don't give you, you can't. And then I realized this was a classic example of the flamboyant times we're living in. I don't care if it's sleet, anything, I wanna make it, man. But, Hail Caesar! The lions come out now fressing up and you'd really flip now. Open the doors! That wasn't funny already. Ate three kids, that was terrible. Now I can't get anyone to make a move, man. And I said, you mean to tell me that, no, man, it's suicide. And I was serious with the cat. I said, well, just take me over and I'll bail. Give me a parachute and I'll bail out there. So the guy said, well, have you ever made it for us? No, what is it to do, man? Just go, that's all, man. Well, you can't do that because you never did it before. Every cat who did it never did it before. It's not an academic thing, as you, you know, any schlubbo pap, and you make it, that's all. So now it's getting, and I really can't believe that I'm not going to make it. You know, something will happen. Now it's about an hour to go, and I see I blew my cool. I can't make it. Blew my cool, and I'm going to lose $2,000, too, soon. So now I see, okay, now I just can't make it. Now it's like half hour. I know I'm not going to make it. I blew the concert. Now I got to get a train to come here. I said, all I know is the train's gonna be the dopey blue velvet seats and cigar smoke and a cheese sandwich with a dot of mustard there. You know. And the train took 11 hours, man. And conductors, you see, already it's very bourgeois to even fly now. You know, 15 years ago, a real status symbol, you know, flying, but now any schlubbo like can make any. Really, man? Yeah, that's cool. I can hear you. It's obvious I'm looking at you, man, so I'm relating to you. What a hanger. What is it? Is it like, well, why don't you, how am I making the second bow? Is it Paco at the second bow? Yeah, it's a jig. Why do you sit way up there? Is it that much less bread? No, I don't want that. That's forget. That's like, no, that was no spritzo. I meant that, man. Like, it's a, what is the taste? What was the scene? How much bread did you have to get in here? 480. So, that's a beautiful Brooklyn hoodlum Fox Fabian sound, right? Hey, go, nutsos yelling in the night. I was a movie yeller, yeah. But if I am not getting through, I want it to you, man. I want you to hear me. Oh, you schmuck, of course you can hear me because you yelled too much. The hell, that's a, yeah, just kind of too much, and it's a good vicious putzo who just wants to yell. Oh, you lost me completely, because I really had Rachmaninoff. You didn't hear me, I want you to hear me. But you heard that, yeah. So you just, no, forget it then. Don't jump and make trouble. Yeah. All right.